Guys, huge news coming from Intel over the weekend. The US government is going to be investing $9 billion into Intel at a nearly 10% equity stake in common stock. They're essentially using unpaid CHIPS Act grants and national security funds to essentially bail out Intel. Today, we're going to talk about the pros and the cons, why this is happening, why I like it, why I don't like it, and you can certainly feel free to put your feelings and thoughts in the comments below, because this is, in my opinion, a big deal. It kind of reminisces to the Wall Street bailouts that we saw back in 2010, right? They're not going to have board representation, but as a result of this bailout, Intel stock jumped about 1.7%. But guess what? The US government isn't alone in investing and bailing out Intel. SoftBank invested $2 billion at $23 a share, becoming a top 10 shareholder, and also reinforcing a much broader AI and semiconductor investment strategy. Additionally, that's not all, but wait, there's more. Billionaire David Tepper increased holdings in Intel while also investing in Nvidia and Taiwanese semiconductor manufacturer TSMC. And you know what's interesting? I recorded an entire video on this, but this comes off the back of Intel announcing that it's planning to cut 24,000 workers. I recorded an entire video. I encourage you to check that out, because I've been following Intel with some piqued interest recently, as they play what I would consider a very important part in this push to bring more semiconductor manufacturing here to the United States. So we're going to talk first about the pros, then we're going to talk about the cons, and we're going to talk about what it means. And this is, in my opinion, an insanely big deal, as we're seeing more data center building, tens of billions of dollars being invested in data center construction here in the United States. Semiconductor manufacturing is a big deal. So let's talk about some of the pros. Let's talk about why this is a good thing, okay? And by the way, if you want to keep up on all the latest news, you should definitely subscribe to my newsletter, AIUpdate.ai. This is for men, guys. How does it impact us as workers? How does this impact our ability to be relevant, respected, financially free in a world that is changing so rapidly? The stuff that we have been doing for the last 10, 20, 30 years is not the same stuff that we're going to be doing over the next decades. It's not the same stuff that our kids are going to be doing. The world is changing too dramatically. So I would encourage you to subscribe to my newsletter, AIUpdate.ai. I'll put a link below. So let's talk about the pros. Why is an Intel bailout a good thing? Okay, so first off, this shores up national security and supply chain issues. Intel right now is one of the very few US companies capable of actually manufacturing chips domestically. The other big one being Nvidia, who recently got approval to sell chips to China. We're not gonna talk about that too much in today's video. We're talking about Intel today, but Intel is very important to national security and supply chain. And one of the biggest exposures I think that the United States has right now is that 90% of global semiconductor manufacturing happens in Taiwan, which is very, very close to China. If China decided to take over Taiwan, and they would essentially control 90% of semiconductor manufacturing and global production. Why is that important? Well, electronics are in everything that we do, from your phones to your cars, heck, my garage door opener, everything. My Ring doorbell. I recently bought a new house, and it's a smart home. Everything, basically everything in the home, from the appliances to the doorbell, everything has these microchips in them. So it's obviously very important on a domestic timeline, or in a domestic sense, but it's also very, very important for national security, okay? Because, you know, these are the same chips that are powering drones, that are powering tanks and airplanes, AI database centers, right? If we're gonna be competitive in this new world, we need to have secure domestic manufacturing of microchips and semiconductors. It is vital. So that is a pro for bailing out Intel. It also really leverages the CHIPS Act and reinforces our America First industrial policy. again, putting a $9 billion stake uses the CHIP Act funds that were meant to secure semiconductor independence. Essentially, it turns our taxpayer dollars into equity ownership rather than grants and subsidies. You may disagree with that. That's fine, put it in the comments below. And this is a passive stake. The US gains upside if Intel recovers instead of just subsidizing it. And if there is also the ability for the US government to invest in another 5% ownership if a stock reaches or falls to $20 per share. So the US government saying, hey, we're gonna fund you, keep pumping out semiconductors, et cetera, et cetera. And this is important for the AI and tech competitiveness on a global scale. Intel is now going to be producing these 2-nanometer, quote unquote, Jaguar shores. And this is an AI chip roadmap to position it as a counterweight to our heavy reliance on NVIDIA and TSMC, kind of breaking up not just the reliance on foreign countries for semi-chip manufacturing, but also reducing the monopoly that NVIDIA essentially has on semiconductor manufacturing and chip manufacturing with their various chips they're pushing. The government backing does help Intel accelerate research and development and maintain, again, this US competitiveness in AI infrastructure. So those are the positives, those are the goods. That's the reason why this is a good thing. But what about the negatives? What are the cons? Well, this is pretty clear to me that there is a moral hazard in picking winners and losers. And this is something that I'm concerned about, because what this does is this essentially, I would consider this a bailout. It weakens market discipline. It kind of shows these companies that we're too big to fail. We can take unreasonable risks. We can waste money. We can pay our CEOs unreasonable, ungodly amounts. Who cares? The US government will come and they have infinite money. They'll just print more money. They'll manipulate the Fed. They'll sell bonds and all this stuff. We can just do whatever the hell we want. Who cares? It's the same thing that the banks did when they were lending out these subprime mortgages and essentially exploded the economy. Right? I don't typically like this. This also leads to capital misallocation, right? You know, $9 billion in equity could generate higher returns and broader innovation if it was allocated across many smaller companies. Why just give the $9 billion to one company? Why not incentivize and create some carrots and sticks for smaller companies that want to innovate and do things better? This is one of the reasons that I'm a big believer in the importance of meritocracy in capitalism. If you take the risks and you execute at a high level, you win. The reality is that Intel has not executed at a high level. They have done the opposite. They're laying off people, they've become essentially obsolete. They were about to be destroyed until the US government came in and said, here's $9 billion, go do your thing. And obviously there's some backroom dealings that are happening and probably certain opportunities that Intel could get that other companies might not, which is kind of a con there. But reality, I think one of the things that we need to think about is, you know, is it better to give Intel a $9 billion or is it better to spread it out? You know, there's this kind of this idea that kind of came up again during the subprime mortgage lending crisis, where these companies were too big to fail. If they fail, they can take these unreasonable risks. And if they fail, the government will bail them out because it would just destroy the economy. But companies need to be allowed to fail, guys. They need to be allowed to fail, right? The problem though, when it comes to semiconductors, is that semiconductors are not your normal type of production. As mentioned before, they're using AI, defense, healthcare, communications, the economy as a whole. You know, making sure that the United States is able to manufacture chips at home is very, very important. Very important. And if this didn't happen, there would be even more reliance on TSMC, the Taiwanese semiconductor manufacturer. They're already producing 90% of the global market. That to me is an exposure. That is a risk. I don't, you know, when I'm doing marketing consulting and building out lead generation, if you said, Mark, 90% of all leads coming to this company come from one source, I would say, well, that's a risk. How do we diversify that? How do we stop all the leads? Because what if that spigot gets cut off? What if our entire lead generation comes from one source? What then? That's a problem, guys. That's a problem, and it certainly is something that needs to be addressed, especially when it's something of such, like, again, if you think about this, China goes in, they take over Taiwan, they take over TSMC, and they say, okay, guys, we're the ones who hold the cards, we're the ones who make all the rules, we're the ones who are going to be able to make all the drones, develop all the factories. That's a risk, no? That's a problem, no? I think so. The other issue that comes up here is if Intel is to go under, tens of thousands of high-skilled jobs could vanish. And again, Intel has already kind of alluded to the point that that's going to happen. That said, you know, in my opinion, I think that it is inevitable that men like you and me, our jobs are on the line, okay? Stuff is going to change, whether or not it's a company going under, or whether it's AI and robotics taking those positions, taking the positions that were previously held by people like you and me. I mean, I record an entire video. I'll post a link to it here. College graduates cannot find jobs, guys. Your kid, your son who goes to school, he's going to come out of school, tens of thousands of dollars in debt, maybe hundreds. He's not going to be able to find a job. And in this video I recorded, it shows that the college graduate unemployment rate has increased from 5.8% to 6.6% just this year. This is a huge jump in the percentage of unemployment, and that is no good. So, you know, does it make sense for us to go in and save a company just so we can save jobs? I don't like the government getting involved, guys. That kind of picking of winners and losers causes a lot of moral hazard, and I don't love it. I also don't love the idea that we are super exposed to a country like China going in, taking over Taiwan, and taking over essentially global production of semiconductors, which are in everything. I mean, heck, I'm walking here, you can see these garbage cans. Pretty soon these garbage cans are going to have semiconductors, and they're going to be picked up by automated robotic garage garbage trucks. All this is going to happen. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And I would anticipate it happens sooner rather than later. But look, I would love to hear your thoughts on this. I think this is a highly contentious issue. It's not black and white. And this is where the conversation happens, guys. And if you have something that's really interesting, if you have a really data-driven kind of thought on this, post it below. If it's really good, I will pin you. I've pinned great comments in the past. Typically, I have my pinned comment is my newsletter, the AI update, aiupdate.ai. But if you have a better comment, if you can bring more value to the community than that, I will pin you, guys. I will pin your comment. So leave the heat below. And I appreciate it. And, you know, on this idea of jobs, the video I covered yesterday, by the way, I'm bringing you videos 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday, and on Sunday we rest. But on Saturday, the last video I recorded, we talked about what Coinbase is doing. Coinbase basically said to all of their engineers, use AI. If you don't use AI, you're fired. And that's what they did. They laid off a bunch of people. The numbers are not clear, but they laid off a bunch of people. And I would encourage you to watch that video. I'll put a link to it here. I think it's a very interesting topic, and it highlights the need to adapt. I know a lot of guys in the comments are critical of AI and don't think they can do their job as well as they do. And that's fair. I think you should have respect for your job. However, you can see what's happening with companies like Coinbase, where if you fail to adapt, you fail to work. And that's not where I want you. That's not where I want to be. All right. I'll catch you there. In the meantime, have a great day. I'll see you, boys. Peace.